We have a problem. Some of the most popular ways to learn about behavior analysis right now aren't in peer-reviewed processes, and it has me really concerned. Yo, Ryan O, behavior analyst and creator, all things behavior analysis. We nerd out on psychology here, and today, a quick overview of the peer review process and some issues going on specifically in the board certified behavior analyst or BCBA behavior analysis world. So first, the peer review process is intended to uphold the quality and validity of both articles and the journals that publish scientific research. With behavior analysis being a scientific field, with our own research journals, this is how we communicate on what we're observing, how we're conceptualizing behavior change, and what our best practices should be based on data and peer review. So how does this work? Let's hop over to Elsevier's website to see how this works. I've got an image here. So there's a whole process of finding a research question, finding the resources to pull it off, being able to actually gather the data, compile it all into something in that introduction, methods, results, and discussion sort of format, and then submitting it. Once it arrives to a publisher like this, you'll see here that they submit, and then the journal asks, is the requirements met of the journal? If not, inform the author and then potential revisions, or it's just done there. Next, the editor is going to have an initial evaluation of the paper, decide whether to reject and inform. If it's deemed worthy, then experts that are asked and agree will be sent it from the editor to be able to read and consume and provide their perspective. The editor decides next steps, reject, revise, or accept based on those experts. And if it needs revisions, which my understanding is it almost always is asked for revisions, then it's returned to authors for them to complete those. Authors then revise and submit the revised paper. The editor and or original reviewers look it back over. Reviewers either re-recommend certain changes or they will decide. If it needs further revisions, you see it comes back over here, goes back through the process. If it's rejected, they are informed that it's rejected. And if it's accepted, it is informed of the author. And it takes roughly 2 years still for this to be able to make it into a final copy. From the beginning of the completion and submission of it all the way to the bottom of this flowchart. It's absolutely insane. You'll see regardless that there's still a thank you for your time and effort, even if it's completely destroyed and rejected. Now there's a lot of details here that you can dive into and you could look at more specifically if you wanted to for each journal. Again, this is just coming from Elsevier and each one is gonna be a little bit different. We actually have an hour or so sitting down with Jonathan Tarbox describing this for behavior analysis and practice. If you're interested, it's called This Way of Doing. You can check it out, the link's down below for more. Now, how does something like a podcast, a video, or a blog post about our field work? I've dabbled in each of these and I can tell you it depends, but most likely it has little to none of this process built in. On one hand, this allows you to create things and share them, which is sometimes great. There are things that journals will not accept that may be crucial information to share, such as recaps of events, marketing materials, things like that. However, as a professor of behavior analysis and an online content creator myself, I see, and anecdotally, a complete lack of process for publishing things that a ton of people are clicking into. This channel alone in 2020 reached over 3 million people. Yet there was only one person, myself, taking into account what should be shared. I will add though that if there was a guest, they will always have the final say and can even remove things afterwards if they want. But still, compared to this process of the peer review process, that's insane. And the numbers seem to be that people pay attention to new media far more than they do clicking into our research journals, etc. You ever looked at the little numbers that shows how many reads or downloads in our research article? It's usually below 1,000. It's insane, but you can find videos, podcasts, things like that that are crossing millions of downloads per year. But the point here is partially, it's just an anecdotal observation and something perhaps that our field should be exploring empirically. We have the ability, we have the methods, we just aren't arranging the resources to investigate these sort of questions. And until then, be cautious, learn from multiple sources and hold some or a lot of philosophical doubt. For every good video blog or podcast, there's just as many that are completely off base due to poorly trained professionals or a lack of process. And this goes for my efforts as well. Let me know what you want to see more of and less of and shape this channel. If you want to learn more about how I leverage social media as a behavior analyst, you can check out actually this newly launched course I just put out there, 7.5 hours of content. That's also available for continuing education because this is not only currently relevant, but directly tied into our ethical changes coming out January 1st, 2022. You can learn more down below at thebehavioracademy.com. And lastly, thank you. This video is brought to people like you by patrons, people that support my efforts financially, because for the last 3 years now, I've actually spent time and lost money, like I actually lose money creating these videos because I think they are important, the field's important, and there are important people doing important work that needs to be heard by people like you. So if this is something you're in for, consider supporting me down below on Patreon, accessing more of the different perks and the different discounts and such below to other cool things. And I hope you learned something, or at least thought about something, right? Thank you, and that's your Daily BA.